Okay, so, I don't want a different color here to sort of represent the different flora. I'm not sure. Oh, you know what? Okay, so we are going to do a. I want a slightly different color here. Maybe more saturated? I don't know, right here. And I'm gonna do that over here, and that's gonna represent the agriculture here. Okay. In and around Klaarg. Yeah, so we're gonna put that there. That's gonna be the agriculture there. We're gonna put a bunch of fields here. Yeah, we're gonna have to. Okay. Okay, so there's gonna be. Okay, so this is a little bit of a tricky thing because it's. Where is all the water gonna be coming from? Okay. So clearly the mountain's gonna be the source of some water. Crunch, 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 munch, munch, munch. So we're gonna need, I think, we're gonna come in like this. We need another river coming in like this. Maybe another river like this. So we're gonna put all these fields right here. So this is gonna be all the agricultural fields right here. I don't know. Let's see. I haven't actually given a lot of thought to Long Bay, like, just what is Long Bay? Let me see now. At least on my notes, it looks like I wanted Long Bay to actually be like split into two, but that's kind of that distance is fairly. I guess on a boat that might be okay. Hey, let me see, let me see. Here to here is a day walking. Yeah, you know what? On a boat, that's fine. I'm wondering if I want Long Bay to be smaller, bigger, or the same size as Klaarg. Hard to say. Let's see. Do 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 do. Kind of want a larger island somewhere, but I don't know where I want to put it. Oh wait, there it is. There's one right there. Woo! I'm smart. I always like think of stuff. Actually, I do surprise myself sometimes. I'm thinking because that I leave stuff for future me sometimes, so that like helps me do stuff. Little islands. Let's put a beach resort in here somewhere since we're near the coastline. Gotta take another bite of this Mexican pizza. I'm trying to think of like what trips I'm thinking of like boats and what they're where they're going to be going and what routes they're going to take and well, make me maybe design sandbars, schools of fishes. Ooh, I gotta come with like a fishing seasons. Let's see, come in, let's see. Making little spots, let's see where people go fish, people go swimming. Well, I have to think not just people, but let's see, think of animals, monsters. Ooh, what kind of monsters do I want to do? Oh yeah, I needed to come up with a boat. I need to think of like boat designs. Are we doing dugout canoes? Are we doing triremes? Are we? I don't think let's. I don't think we really should be. Oh wait. I'm thinking of triangle sails. I don't know what that's called again. The more technical term. It's like. Don't remember when those were developed. If it's before 1000 AD or 1000 CE, I guess I could put them in the game. But if they're like 1500, then that's too new. That's too late. I might put a one more island on there. No, I want to go the other way. I guess like that? I don't know. I'm not, now I'm thinking like, okay, I'm thinking of the Aegean Sea, because there's a lot of aliens, islands. Well, actually, if I'm doing... Again, if I'm looking at the... That Texas coastline going into the wait, what's this? Nuevo León and Tamaulipas, Tampico. Huh. The coastline's pretty smooth, but there's a bunch of like wetlands or something. I don't know if that coastline's artificial or not. I don't think so. It's way too long. It's way too big. It's just the way Google Maps is doing it, because it's... Yeah, I think if... Okay, yeah, I think if the drop-off is... If the drop-off is a steeper going from land to water, like the depth, then we're gonna do more ragged. But this is supposed to be smoother. Let me see now. Since we're way up at the top, okay, I guess from here down we're gonna do really smooth. Just all the way around smooth. See, okay. It's all rotating. Huh. You know, I hadn't really thought about rotating the map. Okay, let me see. Making. I don't. I guess if it's really close to shore, we're not gonna have quite the same erosion forces. I don't know. I hope the geologist doesn't come in here and like starts yelling. See, am I gonna make a sandbar here? I guess I'm making a sandbar here. Okay, there we go. Okay, that part of the water's done, I think. Is it? No, there's always more. There's always more. See, let's do another island right here. I want lots of islands. I don't know, I just really want a broken up coastline, that's why, so. I don't know, it looks cooler to me. It's cooler. I don't think the islands really should be looking like that. They should. Ugh. think they'd be pointing more like this. It's getting kind of hard to keep straight exactly which one I'm supposed to be like doing. E, C, X, whatever, on the keyboard shortcuts, the key shortcuts. Yeah, I have no idea how the Roche is supposed to be right here. I don't know what the currency is supposed to be doing here. See. See you another island. I love islands. Oh, you know what? I have to think of like what the fishermen are gonna look like. And fishermen superstitions. Let's think of some rituals. Launching a boat. Huh. Wonder what to do. Okay. All right. So the other thing is I'm trying to thinking. I'm trying to think. All right. Because I want to put a few things. Have to put a, at least I'm going to put at least one fishing village along the coast here. So I'm just gonna map this off real quick. So we're doing a mountain village right there. We could actually probably do like three fishing villages and make them each. So, 'cause Klaarg to Midfield Crossroads, that's a day. So Klaarg to whatever this is, it's like almost a day. Maybe a day because it has to go up the mountains. And then here is almost a day. I think it's probably a good distance. And it's good to the crossroads right there. Maybe a little spot right there. Cause that's gonna be the long bay thing, and then maybe let's do one more little town village there. Huh. Trying to think. Medieval Germany population density. Medieval demography. Historical urban community sizes. Between 1250 and 1348, huh? Late Middle Ages. Trying to think. $17 million in France and 1300. What's the okay? So France. Now I'm gonna look at what the square or the land area is of France. Area total area 643,801 kilometers. So I need a calculator here. So in France in 1300, it was 17 million. So let's put two. 17 million. Okay, we're gonna divide that. Divide that by 643,801 square kilometers. So about 26 people per square kilometer. Okay, what's the walking distance? Walking distance for a day, 20 kilometers? Let me think. No. Maybe 30 kilometers? So, let me see here. So, if we do from here, okay, that's walking distance. So, along that on the road, we're thinking 20 to 30 kilometers, but it's not a straight line 20, 30 kilometers, it's along the road 20, 30 kilometers. So, that there is maybe 10 to 15 kilometers. Let's say 10 kilometers straight. All right, now I'm thinking like, oh wait, is that gonna match here? Dang it. Okay, so what's... Oh no, now I'm trying to think, what's the size of the U.S.? No. Is that gonna register? Maybe. I'm ballpark. I still think I'm off, but I might be ballpark close. So let's say straight line, maybe 10 kilometers. So 26 people per square kilometer. It's France at the height of the late Middle Ages. Let's see here, wait. Ten by ten. So this is 100 call, okay, wait. Oh. Okay, so this is that's 100 square kilometers. So the amount of population that can fit in there is 2,640. That means Klaarg is pretty small. Okay. Okay, so that means I really have to make things smaller. So okay, so I mean, this is for me to sort of kind of get an idea of how things are. So this is the other thing, is like right there, so That means Oakridge is only going to be like 2,000, 3,000 people in it. That's a pretty small town. I'm trying to think. Huh. Yeah, I might not have this down pat at all, or... Okay, so I'm gonna make these villages very, very, very small, then they're gonna be... Let's see. So this is literally gonna be a few houses. So this is gonna be like maybe 100 people here. Each one of these are gonna represent maybe 100, 200 people. That's it. Maybe, you know what, maybe even less. Let's do like 100 there and then 200 up here. This is again like way, way too detailed. So we'll do like 200 plus. Wait, do we want? How do we want that to be? Do you want that to be? Is that going to make more sense to make that one the bigger population? Now we'll make this 150. Make this one 200. This one like 30. This one like 80. I want a Klaarg to be like 10,000, but that might be too much. I wanted to be higher than that. I wanted to be like 12,000, like 15. Do 14,000 here. $10,000 there. Well, I mean, it's gonna get fuzzy. I guess it's a fantasy world anyway. Let's see, let's do 8,000 here. And we'll do 4,000 here. Because I think population density was a lot higher in other places like China. China had some pretty big cities, if I remember correctly. So, like, 1600 BC... Knossos had 20,000. Memphis 21,000, like Castro 18,000. Let me see, Jerusalem in 1000 BC at 40,000. Luoyang in 700 BC had between 55,000 and 100,000. Yes, so I think I'm ballpark close. Somewhere around there. A lot of weird notes. Okay, let me see. Alright, I need to go do something real quick. Be back in a second. I want another Mexican pizza, but my tummy's getting softer and softer. Okay. This one? Probably shouldn't do like the other part of that doesn't have that kind of texture, so I probably shouldn't be doing this, but I don't know. Huh, I wonder if with the freshwater source it'd be like tainted with because of the salt water, because it's right next to the bay. Really, really, really overthinking this. Yeah, we're gonna take off this right there. See, filling in that water. Water, water, water. see, just fill it in right here, fill it in, fill it in. Oh, it is coming together though, but that kind of like the weird zoom in, zoom out, like. Like, oh, I can see the shoreline. How big is. Okay, so that's 100%. And then like zoom out and like, oh, whoa, how far does it go? Okay, that's just too far. But it is. Oops, not that one. Let's see here. It is kind of fun to do that. I don't know if I'm like too saturated or not. Cause now I'm gonna start to paint this. I'm not gonna like paint it the way I normally paint stuff. So that means I have a lot more colors and stuff. See, here we go. Yeah, I kind of just like did whatever on that end, didn't I? Let me see. I'm gonna make this area right down here real nice green, rising real green. Oh wait, is this supposed to. Oh wait, yeah. Did I do a different color? I think I might have done a different color to represent the different kinds of flora. Oh no. Nerd alert, nerd alert. Okay, let me see here. See, I'm trying to think of the kiss. Yeah, I think I want it to go up in elevation just ever so slightly right here. I don't know. Does it look like a map? I don't know, maybe. Make it work. Like my hero, Tim Gunn. Make it work. Just kind of like blending it in, Yeah. Okay, hold on. So this is gonna be, yeah, I guess we can make it green here. See here. Thinking maybe some of the forests I'm going to put in here are going to be pine forests. Just gonna fill in the color around here. Yeah, I really jump around a lot. Just it grates on my nerves just to keep doing the same blue thing over and over again. But I really need to power through it. Oh, whoa, what did I just do? I don't know. I don't know if the fields would show up like that, because it's a lot of fields. I don't. That sounds like a day or maybe 2 days to get from these farms to the market. Maybe it's okay. See a little. I think I'm just doing like the color of the soil, not really like whether it's dry or not. I really should be thinking about that though. Color. The color edges. I just want them to stand out more. So, back to the coastline. Yeah, let's start like imagining like what we're gonna do for fishing. Okay, are we gonna do jellyfish, sea cucumbers? Trying to think. Ground fish. We have like flatfish, halibut, soulfish, flounder. Okay, lobster. Ooh, let's do lobsters. Trying to think, do we're gonna do I'm saying I don't think I know there's lobsters in the Caribbean, but I don't know if there are lobsters in the Gulf of Mexico near Mexico or Texas. That's a good question. Mm. spiny lobsters are found in almost all warm waters, including Caribbean, Mediterranean, Australasia, South Africa. I'm trying to think of spiny lobster, Gulf of Mexico. Let's see, fisheries at NOAA.gov. Huh. Looks like most of spiny lobsters are actually toward Florida. That's what I was thinking. I think it was more of the Caribbean than it was the Gulf of Mexico. No. They're found along the continental shelf of the southeastern United States from North Carolina to Texas and Bermuda through the Caribbean Sea and south to Brazil. Huh. So, I guess it's possible. I guess we could put them in there. Well, okay, so this isn't quite this. We're not in quite Gulf of Mexico. We're actually doing it slightly differently. Okay, so I'm gonna draw a little spiny lobster in there just to remind me. Although I might not do spiny lobster, I might do like a trilobite just to be funny. There you go, trilobite. Power through. Focus, man, focus. Okay, blue. I kind of want to do some, rock lobsters, spiny lobsters. The fact of the matter is, I'm trolling Ellie Croft on a stream right now, so that's why I pause from time to time. Ho 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 ho. Okay, here we go. Yay! Reaching this city. Oh, we have to come up with names for the towns. I personally do not want like those awkward, like weird fantasy names. I don't want Star Wars names. I kind of want names in English. They don't have to, I mean, it's not that I want the world to be in English, it's just I want something easy to remember. So if this got translated, I would want them to be translated into basically the equivalent of in that target language. So just wanted things to be easy to remember for the players. Almost there, almost there. Almost there, man, almost there. Let's also put a start to think of also, population, flora, fauna? Oh, yeah, we'll do fauna, flora. Just to be sort of contradictive or contrarian. There we go. Let's see what kind of like let's put in like skates. Yeah. See, here we go. Oh yeah, the names. What names? I didn't think of the names. I just got distracted by drawing little animals. Wait, Klaarg? Klaarg is a weird one. Long Bay. I'm trying not to do too many like that. Klaarg. Let's call them Lobster Village. Yeah, one of them was Lobster Village. I'm gonna call them Lobster Village. And up here is going to be chestnut acorn. I will call it acorn for right now. And over here, I'm thinking langoustine, but that's also a lobster, so that's kind of redundant. I'm gonna just go Hubo. Habu. Hatu. Is that a real word? Please don't tell me that's a real word. Hatu. Okay, it looks like some sort of chemical. Let me see. Okay, yeah, it's some sort of chemistry thing. I don't think it's that. Okay, I don't think people are gonna get confused then. I just don't want this weird coincidence. Nice. Okay. I've been doing pretty well all night, but yeah, now I'm starting to mess up on making mistakes about what layer I'm on. Nice. See here. Do I really have to be making this map? Yes, I have to be making this map. Everything, in order to protect the similitude of Goblin Town. Must be as realistic as possible. Okay, yeah. Nice. Oh wait, you know what? I'm gonna put a plateau. Maybe I should put a plateau here. That might be kind of nice. Yeah, I'm just gonna put the kind of a nice little planes here. Actually makes more sense for a village, I think, if it's like on the plains like that. Hopefully that's not too dense. I don't know. I mean, it's the other thing is I'm doing these very sort of distinct cohesive urban areas, right? Like, doesn't... That's not really what would have been happening, right? Like, this would have been loosely sort of knit communities. So we might call it something like that, but it's probably going to be a lot looser than what I'm making it out look to be. I'm going to make it that this area floods a lot. So we're not going to put a lot of... It's a permanent settlement, but it's not... permanent settlement, but we're not going to put a lot of stone structures, I guess, there, because then there's always the possibility that the place will be flooded and destroyed, so... Kind of hard to kind of... Sort of, I don't know, account. I don't know what to describe here, so I'm just gonna put Mud Village right here. Oh, what? Mud Town? Mudville? Mud... Mud Plain? Oh, wait. Yeah, Mud Plain. Yeah, we'll go just call it Mud Plain. That's fine. Caught that early. There we go, I think that looks cool. I'm just trying to think of... All right. That looks cool. I do have to do more of the rivers, don't I? The rivers. Oh yeah, I gotta make this one. Okay, it's just gonna be off. Okay. See. Okay, yeah, I just need the overall shape. I'll mess with the width of things a little bit later. See here. It really should be getting wider as it goes down, as it gets closer, so. Especially now that it hits kind of a more level, kind of flatter plane. There's just less to sort of hold it in. All right, so this is kind of where I'm gonna I guess the river's gonna end right here, about here. Let me see, which one's the one that changes the width of things? Okay. Well, it doesn't seem like it's doing it. Oh, you know what? Because the stupid resolution is so dang high, that's why it's not doing it. I have to like crank it really high because it's just not gonna register. Huh. Making them extreme wiggly, squirrely. Nice. So I never made that a kind of a that river. I mean, I'm just doing this because it looks cool. I don't know if it actually follows any kind of like geological rhyme or reason. You're trying to get it to match. Okay. Oh, it's wrong way. Ah, oh, I'm on the restroom map, that's why. No, not that one either. Okay, there you go. I think that's it. Always kind of it's very satisfying to get it something to look. Like actually ran like to look very random. There's probably some sort of map generator or something like that I could have used instead of doing this. I see. Nice. We're just gonna make a split into two right here. Okay. We'll do another little small river around here somewhere. Wait, that's too big. Okay, squirreling like back and forth, back and forth. Very slow, contemplative. That river might be slightly too large. Just make this thinner overall. These are going to be really wide because they're very shallow. Okay. But these ones up here are. Like, well, these are going to be just a lot of the smaller streams kind of feeding into the larger one. These are going to be. Yeah, let's make this one smaller, actually. Okay, that'll work. Nice. Okay, here we go. Po 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 po. Okay. Let me see. Let's make like a really big, wide spot right here. Very shallow, slow moving. And then we'll have it tighten up a little. Thicken that a little. Trying to think. Yes, we're gonna leave it at that. I'm trying to decide if that river is too wide or not. Hey there, hi there, ho there, everybody. Lose your raid, yeah. Losers have nothing else to do here, so they come here. Losers. Yeah, maybe just a little bit. Okay. Send this out a little. Oh, no, there. Cool. There we go. Goblin Town is dead. Goblin Town is never dead. Goblin Town is just like disco. It never dies. Huh, wait. Trying to think. Jeez. I'm really, because I've done a little bit of a map for Klaarg already, so I'm like, how, I don't know if I'm messing up its coastline here or not. I can't remember. I mean, technically spoilers, so I don't know. I don't know if any players will actually make it out this far. Ho ho ho. Or if I'll be able to kill you fast enough. Ho ho ho. Why would you miss Saturday? Oh, wait, yeah, you have to do something, huh? You have something about dogs or sitting. Dogs practically take care of themselves. Yeah, I know dogs like that. Most of the time they do it just because they're dogs and they want to play or something like that. They don't mean anything by it. It's still irritating. Oh. Well, I guess if you mess with the equalizer, you might make it so that it's the mic doesn't pick it up very well. Oakley doakley. Hey there, hi there, ho there. What you doing this evening? Okay, now I gotta turn on all these things back on. I honestly can't remember. Darn. Okay. Mm. Okay, I'm trying to think. Okay, I remember now. So there's the ones on top are slightly bluer tone versus the ones on the bottom, because it's supposed to signify the different flora, the different plants versus the top and the bottom. Right, so southern facing part of the mountain versus the northern facing part of the mountain. And I forgot there's a lake up here. Oh wow, I forgot that I put a lake up there. I can't remember what that's for. I know this is a mining town village thing, this mining operation that has to be fishing. This is a crossroads thing. That's another crossroads thing. That's an actual town that's supposed to gate things. That's a fishing village. Okay. Oops, not that one. This one. So, what are we doing here? Okay. So I think we do need to change the tone. The sort of the hue that we're working with here. We're gonna do this one. Since it's gonna be a little bit rainier here on this part of the coast. And all this rivers and streams and stuff. Okay. Trying to think of how hard I want it to. All right. Okay, so here we go. So this is supposed to be a plane, so we have to get this little bit of a mountain range here to kind of like to sort of kind of fade out into it. You know what? No. We're gonna keep the other color. We're gonna keep that other color right here. Just there, though. Okay, so we need a little bit of dark there. I'm trying to think of how this is supposed to work. Okay. So we need to do this color here because that's part of everything next to the river is going to be really green. Okay, I need to rearrange my colors here. My color palette. Ooh, on the wrong layer. Oof, 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 so exciting. All right, I also have, I don't know. We can start make up stories about this stuff. Let's pick up some ghost stories. Yeah. Okay, so we're gonna do like, we have to do haunted roads. Like a headless horseman. But let's make it funnier. A buttless horseman. How does he ride the horse? I don't know. That's what makes it a scary story. Haha. He lost it in a freak. What's it like screening accident? Let me see. Mesh screening. I know he was sitting too long playing video games, and then eventually the doctors had to amputate it. That sounds really dumb. Oh, no. Wrong layer. See, that's why I do that. That's why I have that little the red outline to the setting to make sure I don't do that. Okay, trying to think here. Because I mean, I've been mumbling and babbling on about population density. How many calories can be produced per acre, right, to support the certain populations, and then of course. Now I'm thinking like, okay, there's a lot of space here. Clearly people can do stuff. Oh, you know what? Let's go back to this map. What did I do here? Let's see, present day. Klaarg is indigo. So that's mostly human. The yellow is dwarf. Green is goblin. Okay, so we're doing in a little bit of magenta, which is hobgoblin. So we could sneak in some like ancient like dwarf stuff in here. What did I do here? Oh, all goblin. The great goblin empire. Machu Pikachu. Oh, humans from across the sea brought chickens. Okay. Okay. Okay, good. So 4,400 years before present. Okay. So we can put some like dwarf stuff in here. Just we just need like an obnoxious color to kind of signify where we're putting it. Okay, so we'll put like dwarf stuff in here. I don't know. But these are ruins, okay? So this is like broken temples used for ritual, of course. Thank you. Give me a chicken pox. You know what? Wait, England's pretty flat, so that's why they have all those dang lithics or megalithics. What would you do for an area that's not flat? Okay, I'm gonna do ruin. We're gonna just spitball here. Old mines. Old temples. Ritual. Gonna be a little bit hard to get it to blend seamlessly, but I'm up for the challenge. I'm super smart. There's still a seam. How dare you? Enhance. Enhance. Maybe I don't know what I'm doing. No, it's the children that are wrong. Think that's part of the problem there. I am staring at pixels. Probably should stop doing this. See. Oh, whoa. Okay, so this is how far. This is as close as I should be doing it. see here. That one might be acceptable. Everything's really, really, really messy. I caught Indy's yawns now. Yawn. I'm sighing because I'm trying to think of where the apex of the mountain is, like the top of the ridge here. Because that's gonna determine which way the river, the water flows down, right? Like things like snow melt. Oh yeah, I gotta turn down that hardness down a little. Yeah, I might have to just blur that edge a little bit just to get it to not have that weird funny seam. It's too hobgoblin thing down here. I don't know. Some weird hobgoblin thing down here. Let's look at the statue of a guy. This is a Napoleon joke. Okay, so we're gonna put like a hobgoblin thing something down there. Do a portal to hell right here. Right on top of a hell mouth or gate to hell. Right there. That'll be the surprise. Swallow up the party when they're not looking. Fortunately, no one's paying attention right now. No, you're not. You're gonna forget this. All right, fine. Anna knows. Does Dagmar know? How does Dagmar know? So you're gonna put Anna and Goblin down? Are you really gonna do that? Are you gonna put Anna and Goblin down? I dare you. Tech, Hannah's gonna suffocate in that backpack. Are you claustrophobic? Is Anna claustrophobic? Okay, then. I'm wondering what Dagmar feeds Anna. Does Anna actually get to eat every day? Or is that how Anna stays so small and that she can fit in the backpack like bonsai tree, just kind of starved? All right, very good. Okay, we're going to change this ridge, actually. This has a change right here. Because we needed to bend in such a way so that it... Because it needs to make room for all of this down here. No, with the different kind of colors in the soil, I'm thinking, huh, is this gonna be, see, different kinds of rock colors, different kinds of soil compositions. What can we do with that? Aren't the cliffs of Dover white? That's because of the high, I know that it's in calcium, but the calcium is because of all the pink shellfish fossils in it, right? Shock. Yeah, okay. Deposited during the late Cretaceous. Interesting. Okay, so, well, if it's that big of a deposit, I don't think it's gonna be just that. But it's interesting to think about. Okay. Seam is pretty noticeable if you stare at it, but starting to blend in pretty well, so that's nice. Excellent. Yeah, okay, good. Right. Yeah, I think I need to call it a night. I gotta get up to do something tomorrow. But let's kind of brainstorm a couple other things. What else do we want to put in here? You're not feeling sleepy? Let's see, what else can we do in here? I know I want to put. They're not pirates. We're not putting pirates right here, we're putting smugglers. Oh yeah, we gotta put that thieves village here. Or hideout. Or what's his face? What are we gonna do with Long Bay? This would be North Shore. South Shore. This would be the Jersey of the area. Gotta put the boss in there somehow. All right. All right. Looks pretty good.